The Boston Bruins lost in the second round of the playoffs last year, but this team is still a contender despite some significant offseason changes. Let's bring in Emily Benjamin, covers the Bruins for us, based in Boston for NHL.com. Emily, you agree with me? I think even though they have a lot of changes, we'll go through all of them, the Bruins are still a contender.
Absolutely. And that was something that Brad Marchand and Patrice Bergeron really made clear that they wanted as a priority for Cam Neely and Don Sweeney this offseason. They said, you know, we're still here. We're still ready to go. They don't know how many more years that they might have.
Right.
And so they want a team that can contend for the Stanley Cup. And I think that is the hope in Boston. Whether it's the reality in Boston, I think is a little more unclear.
Well, let's see where can hope meet reality. And I think it starts in goal. Number one, it's a huge change. Obviously, Tuukka Rask is not there right now. I don't want to say any more because it's just not right now. He's not signed. He's at surgery. He's rehabbing. He will only play for the Boston Bruins if he plays in the NHL again. That could be this season. It likely wouldn't be until January or February anyway. So they brought in Linus Ullmark, who was with the Buffalo Sabres last year. And look, Ullmark signed a four-year deal to be the number one. He wasn't a bad goalie on a bad team. He was actually pretty good with the Buffalo Sabres, and they were not good around him. So he comes in as the number one. Jaroslav Halak's not there anymore. So the goaltending depth is not what it once was. Jeremy Swayman is likely the backup now to Ullmark. We'll see how it plays out. But I think it starts right there with the Bruins. When we talk major changes, can Ullmark be the guy that the Bruins expect him to be? If yes, they are a significant, serious contender. If no, we could be looking at Tuukka Rask come February.
I would say that I think it's a little less clear-cut than maybe you think with Ullmark and Swayman. I mean, Swayman obviously came in. He had a great 10-game sample size. He went 7-3, you know, 1.50 goals against, 945 save percentage. Obviously, very small sample. Teams will adjust.
Yeah.
He's a rookie. He's 22. But this is the guy that the Bruins are hoping will develop into sort of the heir apparent, notwithstanding that they did just sign Ullmark to that contract. So I think that their best hope is maybe it's more of a 50-50 split. Swayman continues his development. Maybe he isn't quite at number one status yet, but he comes in, continues that development. They can split time. And then they have a lot more leeway to see what happens when Tuukka Rask is ready.
Yeah.
And Rask, as you said, has made it clear this is the team that he will play for. And he's willing to be sort of a mentor in some ways when/if he comes back. So we'll see if that happens. But we got a couple months before that's even on the table.
Yeah, no question about it. And you're right about Swayman, but I just don't think they can't be ready to just hand this kid the reins at this age. So he's certainly looks like he could be a big time member of the Bruins in the future. Let's see how he plays this season. We'll see how the goaltending plays out, but it's a big question. It's really maybe even less of a question, but just a fascinating thing to watch with the Boston Bruins this season. The big question for me, another one, David Krejci's gone. He's back playing in the Czech Republic. David Krejci was a staple for the Bruins right behind Patrice Bergeron in the lineup. He is now gone. For years, Emily, they were looking for a left wing to play with David Krejci. They got Taylor Hall. Now they don't have David Krejci. So who fills that role?
For now, it looks like they're going to start with Charlie Coyle. This is a guy who's signed to a six-year deal. They're hoping that he can bounce back from last season. He really did have a tough season last year. 16 points, 51 games is not what you're looking for. But at the same time, he had off-season surgery. He said the other day that he is might have some limitations coming into training camp, but should be 100% to go by the start of the regular season. So the first hope is Charlie Coyle fills that role, potentially with Taylor Hall, maybe Craig Smith on the other side. But then there's sort of that question mark of, could this be the year that Jack Studnicka makes his mark? Could he make the jump? This is a guy who they've been looking at for a long time as potentially a top six center, maybe an heir apparent to one of those two guys, Bergeron or Krejci. He looks good. As far as anyone has seen this summer, he has bulked up. He has worked really hard to maybe put himself in position that he could take over, say, the third line center spot, and maybe even contend for that second line center spot.
And the other thing we could look at here is the D too, because I like their D. It's younger than what we've seen. It got that way last year too. Charlie McAvoy and Brandon Carlo really taking ownership of the D, you know, last year, and now they get to do it for a full 82 game season this year. We talk about the goaltending. We know how we look. We know how Patrice Bergeron and David Pastrnak and Brad Marchand are going to play. I don't think there's any questions there. There's question at the center position. I think there's, whereas a year ago, maybe there was a lot of questions about the D. I don't think there's as many questions about the D. Would you agree with that?
I think that's fair. And I would add Matt Grzelcyk's name to that list. I mean, he's a guy who, especially when he's playing with McAvoy, really forms a great tandem up there in the first defensive pairing. I don't know if they'll go there all the time. Derek Forbort might slot in sometimes with McAvoy. We'll see how it sort of all shakes out. But they do have those three guys, McAvoy, Grzelcyk, and Carlo, who are sort of taking the reins and maybe transitioning to a new generation of Bruins defensemen. And this is going to be a big year for McAvoy, especially. He's an RFA at the end of the year. This is maybe a year where he has made big jumps, but maybe he is making an even bigger jump with sort of coming in knowing that he has ownership of that defense.
Yeah, and they added Nick Foligno too. We can't forget about that. Another veteran leadership presence. I don't know how many goals they'll get out of Nick Foligno, but he's certainly going to be a pain in the butt to play against. There's no question about that. He was that way in Columbus for years, a little bit with Toronto, and now he will be in Boston. And again, like we said off the top, I think this is a playoff team. I think they're still a serious contender with some more, maybe more question marks than the Bruins have had in the past.
That's fair. That's fair. This is a team that is hoping to be a Stanley Cup contender. I think is certainly a first or second round playoff team, just based on their potential and the guys that who have done it year after year after year, some promise they have on that defensive side, the coaching they have. But I you know, can they make it to the conference final? Can they make it to the Stanley Cup final? You know, those are some big questions, and it's not like they play in an easy division to get that far.
No, it's a tough division, no question about it. But she's Emily Benjamin. She follows the Bruins, covers the Bruins for us all season. So follow her work on NHL.com.